Hey, g'day, it's Prezo. Welcome back to my workshop. Now, what you saw me do just then is a bit of a hallmark of an amateur machinist, and that is trying to face off a part in the chuck with the tip of the lathe turning tool set either too low or too high. And what you get when you do that is a little tiny projection from the end of the part, and that can be both unsightly and untidy, but it can also be dangerous. If that were the top of something like an adjusting knob and you're running a hand over that all the time, you can catch your skin on it and cause injury. So what do? Well, you can set the tip of the lathe turning tool by trial and error, and you just keep facing off parts until you don't get that little pip in the center anymore. Or you can use some sort of a tool or an indicating tool to allow you to check the height of the turning tool and get it set correctly. So what I want to do today in this video is to show you how to make such a tool. So let's get started. To calibrate the tool setter, you're going to need a cutting tool which you know is accurate. So you can do that by setting up a piece of work in the chuck, in the headstock chuck, and then repeatedly facing that off and adjusting the height of the tool until you can see that it's leaving a clean face with no pip in the center. Now your tool setter can fit into either the tailstock chuck or the headstock chuck, whichever one is available. And then you simply lower this adjusting screw down onto the tip of the tool and then check the bubble level on top. Now you can see that it's wrong here, so what I'll do is I'm going to turn that grub screw or that adjusting screw until the bubble is in the center of the reference marks on top. When you get it there, you can simply tighten the M4 grub screw, socket head grub screw, and because of that little copper pad in there, you don't need to over tighten it. It's just to stop this from moving accidentally. Now you can also check inverted tools, so let me just take this one out. Now this is an inverted parting tool that I use quite often on this lathe. So we can spin the whole tool setter around and bring our inverted tool up to that pad there, and once again check the level on top. This one's a little bit harder to adjust, but you can get it from underneath. And again, when you see the bubble is in the center of the reference marks, you know you're right. And we'll lock that one off there. So that's it. Very easy, very simple. And you can set up a number of tools very, very quickly using this technique. So let's do another one. You can see that one's way off, so what I'll need to do is actually adjust the height of my tool holder. And that's it there. So again, very easy to set up, very easy to use. It's a visual thing, you're just looking at it and you can see at a glance whether you got it right or not. So there it is in the headstock chuck. So same procedure, just lower that down, check the bubble on top, see if it's in the middle of the reference marks. Now you might be wondering what I used before I made the Preso Perfect Lathe Tool height setter, and this is what I used here. Now this tool is also able to be calibrated, so if you loosen off that grub screw there, you can raise and lower this column, and you can calibrate this tool against a lathe cutting tool of known accuracy. And in practice, you sit that on the saddle, and then you can run a regular tool bit up underneath this little plate here, or if it's an inverted tool, you run it down against the top of the column. It works, but the only problem is that I can't get this tool anywhere near the tip of my turning tool. So even if I run the compound slide all the way back, it still can't get this setting tool over far enough to engage on the tip of the tool. So the only way to check it is to rotate the whole tool post, and you can check it that way. The only problem with that is that usually you don't notice that you need to adjust the top, the tip of the tool until you started doing a facing cut or a parting tool cut, and in that case you probably already set your DRO or you've already set your dials on your cross slide and compound slide to a known position, and as soon as you rotate the tool post you lose all of that reference. So in practice it's a bit of a nuisance really. If you remember to check before you even start, it's fine. But quite often you take a tool out and you want to sharpen it and put it back, and then you've got a problem. So I'm still going to use this, but in practice I think I'm going to be using the Preso Perfect tool setter more often. Well, that's it guys. I hope you enjoyed my entry in the Rough Cuts 2022 video challenge. And as it turns out, I actually made two of these tools. Now, one of these is going to be given away as part of a prize pack for when I get to 30,000 subscribers. Now, not there yet, getting close, and when I do reach that milestone, I'll make an announcement. So I'm going to give away one of these tools plus a series of other prizes that was supplied to me by James Long at Boring Research. So I'll do up some prize packs, there'll be some stickers and stuff like that as well, and I'll make an announcement about that in due course. So for now, I'm going to say cheerio. I've got some more exciting video coming out soon, so stay tuned for that. And if you're not a subscriber, you know what to do. Okay, it's Preso. See you later.